Hi, and welcome back to the SHTICK. We're in Melbourne at the moment, and at this very time, we've got a comedy festival on. And one of the performers there is my guest in the studio today, and his name is Stephen Harris.
Hi, thanks for having me.
That's okay, nice to see you. And tell the audience, what's your shtick?
I do these live shows, which are sort of like autobiographical storytelling. My stage name is Magic Stephen. I've been doing it for about 3 years.
This is your third show in the comedy festival.
Yeah, it's my third show in this festival. And this one is in a place called Southbank Theatre, which I think is a...
I've never heard of it.
Yeah, it's...
It's an obscure place.
It's the home of the MTC, Melbourne Theatre Company.
Oh, right, okay.
Next door to the MRC, Melbourne Recital Centre.
All right, so we know where it is.
Southbank Boulevard.
Yeah, because no one that I know has ever performed there, but you're going to be there between the 12th and the 14th of April.
Yeah, that's right.
Doing a stand-up kind of deadpan-style, profound... how do you describe your comedy? Because I think it's funny.
I usually just list other people's descriptions because... I've got my own issues with each of the descriptions, so I don't really want to, like, I wouldn't really want to call myself a comedian.
So you're a poet? Because you do beat poetry?
Some people have described it as poetry because I read out of a notebook. Mm-hmm. When you see someone reading out of a notebook, I think the conclusion that you would draw is that's poetry, because those are the only people who read in public out of a notebook. But I don't really know anything about poetry. I have trouble finding poetry that I connect with by writers. Some of it I really like. Then some people call it autobiographical storytelling, but I don't really want to be linked to the global trend of storytelling becoming popular in the last few years.
Mm-hmm. So you are basically a unique artist. You've created your own genre.
I would never say that, but
no, I'd say you really a kind of you work on the deadpan area of comedy in a sense, in that you don't, you know, you're not sort of funny in the usual comedic way.
Yeah, I think that sounds valid. Yep.
So you've just come back from an international tour. You've been to quite a few places since you've left Melbourne, and you went to Moscow and Berlin.
Yeah, I did some shows.
Greece?
Yep, Athens. Did a show in Athens.
London?
London.
Brighton?
Yep, Brighton, UK.
UK and Bristol.
Yep.
Which is a funny place in itself. You don't have to, you just have to walk up to someone in the street in Bristol, they'll be funny.
Yeah, you know? That's true. People there were very funny.
Yeah. And now you've come back to do this show, and what do you see your shtick taking you into? Have you got some sort of an ambition to where to go?
No, I think it's just from moment to moment. I don't really know what's going to happen, but I know I'm doing this show, this festival, and pretty happy about that.
Yeah, so you're basically living here and now. You're not an ambitious, you're not wanting to be a star.
I think I am ambitious, but I don't really know exactly what I want to do.
You do it in a very low-key fashion, and you've got some radio rounds. You're doing one today, and you're going to be on radio. And this is your only television appearance on the shtick. How lucky are we to have you on the show? And I cited you the first time at this Purim Heart Speaker event that our other guest, Paz, organized, and you're actually appearing in this little clip as an audience participant. But we're going out with this wonderful clip of Tumbalalaika by Husky and Gidon Price, with other performers and a bit of dancing from Lauren and Azra. So we're part of a tribe. I'm really happy to have welcomed you to the Shtick and welcome to the tribe, back to Melbourne. It's good to have you back, Stephen.
Thank you.
I wish you all the best for your comedy festival show and looking forward to keeping up with your progress in your career as a stand-up comedian.
Thank you.
It's been great. And until next week, we'll see you on the Shtick for some Pesach coming up. And until then, shalom.
Shalom.